8-3.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Oh, no, he lost the football.
On plays like this, where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. This will be from 56 yards out. And his kick is good. He got every bit of that one, as it's good from 56 yards out. We've seen some big kicks in the NFL the last few years, and that one might just rank right up there.
And you know, you can hear the crowd react, right? But I was focused in on the sideline and watched them absolutely erupt. I don't know how many of them thought that he was actually going to make that kick, but how about how they felt when the ball went over the post?
Fielded about a yard deep. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Carolina getting set to take the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
A running play on first down, and it turns into a fight just to get back to the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
Give him 10 there, good enough for a Panther first down. They'll run on first down. It's Foster. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. This is West. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. This will be a loss of 3, and now a much tougher third down looming.
I know the speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Jones now. Operating from the gun. Jones hit, and the ball's out. So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah, that stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but the other team doesn't get it. That's a huge difference in the ball game. And in this case, they were able to retain possession.
Here's the Panthers punter now, as he's on here to punt it away. And a nice special teams job here. This is going to be down inside the 10 at the 7-yard line.
Absolutely love the flexibility of these punters. Their leg drive, able to get it way up in the air. And that allows the punt team to get down there and down it inside the 10, because they've had some time.
On first down, nothing opening up really on the running play. Give him maybe a yard, and it'll be second down. They'll keep it on the ground. It's Newman. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd-and-9 situation. So the Colts in possession of the football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And he will take this up to about the 8-yard line. And now right out of the 2-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. The Colts send out their punter as he'll punt it away for the second time. they'll take it just outside the 40. A good kick, 49 yards, just three on the return. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Throwing, Jones. Ginn has it complete. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't they?
Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time, really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
He gets this away. It's a good one, drawing toward the sidelines. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds. Here comes the Indianapolis offense now as they get set to take over. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. If they get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play, but if they don't, let's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. Quick hitter here, it's complete. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Second and 5. Well, nearly picked. And maybe lucky there. This guy doesn't drop any defensively. Third down. They come up now. Third and 5 following the incomplete pass. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter. The Colts send out their punter as he'll come on to kick this one away. We'll call that a 49-yard punt with a return of just 2. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Now the Panthers offense, they get set to come back onto the field. They have a little bit of time here to get into field goal range, not much. A tie game, you don't want to do anything crazy, right?
I agree with you on that one. Risk reward, okay? If you go for it, what is the absolute reward on this? But the risk is probably greater. Run the clock out, get to overtime, and try and win it there.
All right, we'll see if they do just that. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. Give him 10 there, good enough for a Panther first down. So four quarters wasn't enough, and we are off to overtime. Don't change that dial. Overtime in a playoff game. Awesome setup. Remember, the rules the same as they would be in the regular season.
That's exactly right, Brandon. Remember, the receiving team, if they score a touchdown, game is over. But if they kick a field goal or don't score, the other team gets a chance to get the football. They get a possession. If they go down and score, they win the football game at that point. If both teams kick field goals, we keep playing. If a defense scores, let's say the receiving team gets the ball, doesn't score, or they throw a pick six or fumble, gets picked up, the defense scores, game over. But here's the best part. In the regular season, only one period is played. We could call it a tie. Here, we're going to play until we have a winner.
And now back out comes the offense. Set for their first drive here in overtime, and this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, That gets doubled, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team. And that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
It's been loud in here so far. Now the throw here, complete on the right sideline. That one, a first down pickup of 8. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Now Foster on the toss. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A big run there, 29 yards and a first. Nothing too fancy there, a simple toss left, but for whatever reason, the defense, they didn't seem ready for it.
Let me continue on with your thought right there, because after the play was over, I kept my eyes on the defenders. Watch them get off the ground, going back to the huddle, shaking their heads and kind of pointing to each other like, what just happened there? I think you were onto something.
On the draw, this is West. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4. You go! On 2nd down and 4, Jones, his throw caught right around the 6. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. 19 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have it 1st and goal. Charles, you get into these overtime situations, that's not a bad guy to dial into.
Well, when you have to have plays, especially in a spot as you just described, we're in OT, you've got to go to the guys you can trust and you know are going to make the plays. Well, they say, it's not the X's and the O's, it's the Jimmys and the Joes.
Jones, and this is incomplete.
Well, you know you don't want to make a mistake in that area, so you make sure you make a smart throw. Throw it out towards the sidelines. If you overshoot your guy, so be it. It's just the incompletion that we saw there.
Now a 2nd down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete. Biggest play now in this opening drive of overtime. This is 3rd and goal. Here's Jones. From the gun, he'll throw. And it's caught! Touchdown! They win the Super Bowl! Super Bowl champions. And their remarkable season ends in the most remarkable of ways. They get to put next to their name, Super Bowl champion.
And they can't ever take that away, can they?
Nope.
That lasts forever. So good to see the emotion when it's all said and done. You see the hugs, you see the guys sharing, the collective happiness. Makes me want to carry you around a little bit on my shoulders to celebrate the triumph, and congratulations to them, a fantastic season.
And they end this year just how everybody wants to end the year, holding the Lombardi Trophy. What a season for them. What a ride it's been for us as well here in the booth. For Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gunn. Thanks for watching, everybody. We will see you next season right here on EA Sports.